Hi everyone, I'm Adrien. I'm the senior engineer for the downtrack tunnel on HS2C1. We're about to onboard Cecilia, the tunnel boring machine, which is about to mine this 10-mile drive. Follow me. So we are now standing on Cecilia. We are at the back of the 170 meter long TBM tunnel boring machine, which is about to achieve the drive. This is in this position at the back of the machine where we extend all our utility network and slurry network that will supply all the material required towards the tunnel boring machine. Let's continue our visit. I want us to stop here to show you an impressive innovation on this machine. The segments which are used to build the ring will be supplied using the multi-services vehicles that we come here. The segments are stacked when they are delivered, and we use this robot to pick up the wood wedge which are installed in between the segments to avoid any workforce to access this danger area. That's an impressive technology which we are impressed to have developed and deployed on this machine. We are now at the back of gantry 1. This is where the magic happens. We're just the first gantry at the back of the tunnel boring machine. It's very noisy and we have all the hydraulic, pneumatic and slurry equipment which are working just behind us. That huge slurry pump just on my left hand side is pumping up to 1500 meter cube an hour of slurry and material that is being excavated in the excavation chamber. Just at the back on the gantry 2, we are using this segment crane to lift the segments from the MSV, which will be just sitting at the back of us, and we'll drop the segments one by one on the segment feeder just below our foot. The segment feeder will bring the segment to the build area where we are going now. We are now standing on the top of the segment erector. This is the area where we erect our rings. This is where we build the tunnel, literally. One ring is composed of 7 segments, each of them weighing up to 8.5 ton. And these segments will be lifted and put in position using this equipment. We will lift the segments and install them with an extreme precision up to a millimeter. Let's go just in front of us in the Manlock, just the last door before being in contact with the ground. We are now next to the screw conveyor. This is the screw that picks up all the material, endless screw that picks up all the material from the excavation chamber straight into the big box behind us where we mix it with water before pumping it with the big pump we saw a few minutes before. We are now in the core of Cecilia. This is where the magic happens again. We see now the cutter heads turn in, powered by these 10 motors that we see in green. Now the machine is advancing and we'll just go upstairs next to the Manlock, which is the last 2 doors before entering the excavation chamber. Behind this door, we are in contact with the excavation slurry, and this is the excavation chamber. This Manlock are the last piece of equipment that we use to maintain the pressure in the excavation chamber. We'll use this chamber to either compress or decompress the atmospheric pressure to allow someone to access in the excavation chambers. We see now the tunnel at the back of us. The TBM has to go north, and we are mining below the Chiltern hills for the next 3 years. Let's go now in the operation cabin where everything is controlled. We are now in the control cabin. This is where the engineers, in coordination with the pilot, will make decisions to steer the machine and to adjust the excavation parameters. Just behind your back, on the top screen, you will see what's happening in the excavation chamber. Vivek, the shift engineers, Michael, the TBM pilot, is the man controlling the machine under the supervision of George, which is managing this shift. This is the machine running the TBM alongside with 17 miners on the ground. It's a very noisy area here. We just hear the flints hitting the slurry pipes on our return line, and we have all the hydraulic and electric motors on my right hand side, giving all the power to the machine to drive forward. Our mining team will need to live on this machine for the next 3 years, so all the welfare is provided on the machine. The canteen, and obviously the most important, the coffee machine. Last but not least, I hope we'll never get to sit in this room during an emergency, but we are now in the rescue chambers where the mining team can shelter in case of emergency. This is now the end of the visit. I've been very pleased to walk you around Cecilia. We're now going to mine towards the Chiltern Hills for the next 3 years. I was happy to have you on board. Thank you.